Dudley. Mission Bureau, copy 194, Dudley. Hey. Hoyoyoshi, Chris was sleeping. So we said, she gave him this yesterday, this. Rabbi said, if you meet the same chief as Kavona, the first posuk in Kriya Shema, you have to have Kavona. If you don't have the Kavona, knowing what the words mean, that you feel that you're accepting the Omach Shemayim, you're not Yotze. You have to repeat it. Same thing as Moshen Komach Shemayim. Saying the words without being in touch with what the words mean, and having a sense of what you're saying, it has to be repeated. That's also Kabbalah's Moshe Shemayim. That's why I repeat it. Okay? Imo Yoshe, the person was sleeping, and comes to the Tzimtzum in Kriya Shema. Mitzar noso, Meiri noso, Achinikro posuk rishon, Uer mamush. Yeah, actually, whatever it takes, even if you have to poke him, he has to wake up, he has to say Kriya Shema. And he has to be wide awake, because he has to, as we say, he has to be in touch with what he's saying. Kavil him tzaroso kishikro, Uer mamush. But the rest, even if he just mumbles the words, as long as he says the words, because again, whether it's mitzvah saying shikas kavona, or as long as he's in touch enough to just know what he's saying, he doesn't have to have anything beyond that, it's okay. He has to be fully in touch what he's saying is only the first pasuk. Beyond that point, even if he's semi-dozing, as long as he knows he's saying the words, that's enough. He's saying the words. He's literally awake. Japi Shukori Misnamnein, although he reads it where he's dozing, Yotzo, the Gemara says, what's Misnamnein? The Gemara says that you speak to him, he'll respond. But if you ask him anything, that it needs some level of reflection or a svara, to give a reason, he's not able to respond at that level. Is everything okay? Yes. That he can respond. But by the way, give him some numbers to compute, the counting. That he's not there. Yehagov v'din shosi v'shikor. What about a person that had drunk? He's semi-intoxicated. Ayin l'kamon sim tzaites sifal. Okay. It's in the word of the Pesach Mishan. Ayin sifkot yiral du'adim boshen kodosh. Hey. It's namnei. Du'adim ones acher. Hanvatl kavonoso yotzo. Some other reason. There's a ton of can't focus. There's so much noise, people are speaking. All you can do is just say the words. The first pasuk, you have to put your fingers in your ears and really make the greatest effort to be able to be in touch with what you're saying. Beyond that point, as long as you're saying the words and you know what you're saying, that's enough. Hari dalkon korok kulo avodim nishtakea pishino vlo korok. What about a person after the first pasuk, he just falls asleep and he doesn't say the words? Minimally, you have to say the words. The Dadi is Sholish Deus Beda Poskim. It's in the three positions. Yeshom Derak Posk Rishon Vadu Benatov. You mentioned this. There's one position among the Rishon and the Poskim. Only the Dorais is the first Posk. Shmaisel Shemetin Yeshom Vadu. Everything else is Rubinov. Yeshom Rikol Apashu Shon Benatov in the first paragraph. That's Kabos Moshamayim, which is. The Yishomen Degam Ashni Uminator. The second, Voyim Shomor, also, the first two paragraphs of the Raiso, Parshas Tzitzis Kuli Am Uminator. The third parish, what do we say? It was the same thing as Tzitzis Mitzrayim. It's unrelated to the first two. Kedei Lask Tzitzis Mitzrayim, Tikul Lask Tzitzis Mitzrayim, Tikul Lask Tzitzis Mitzrayim, but they enacted it, you should say it's not a creature. Ayin Lekam Sivu Sar, Sama Zayim, Shabruah, Kshar Shem Shem. You know, when you repeat creation, it's not so simple. Allah has been Dabi Mayra Vorbi, after the flood. You have to repeat Shema. Actually, you have to repeat Shema. Right? But you have to repeat because Kriyishma is based on the Shachot. When people are asleep, they're not sleeping. What about Zeichet Sisra? You have to say it twice a day, during day and night time. Right? Does it say when people are sleeping? After flood, it's not so simple. It's not night time. After flood. For instance, if one lights in Kabbal Shabbos, Friday afternoon after Friday. It's a valid acceptance. You're bound by the laws of Shabbos, I mean, there's no liability of the death penalty. But in terms of you're bound by the laws of Shabbos. If you want to light candles, Shabbos candles, the light before Plag, it has no value whatsoever. It's a brothel of Atola. Second Yom Tov afterwards, because it already has relevance in the night. So I'm saying, one would say the third paragraph of the Shema after Flag.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But the after Pinder. Krishma, no question. Because there, the Torah says, when people are sleeping, after Flag, people are not sleeping. Or maybe the third paragraph, which is Exodus Mitzrayim, as long as it has a semblance of nighttime, and if Flag does have relevance in the night, we light, if you like the Hanukkah candles after Flag. But the Yom Tov, will be supposed to light by nighttime. I don't know why. The answer is, of course, if the flag it already identifies as a nighttime period. But it's not a time that people are sleeping.
So it says that you know earlier, 5 months. Are you saying that you skip the third paragraph?
That's what I'm addressing right now. Maybe you would not say the third paragraph. The only thing is, he says over here, the titul haskim is not Kriyashma. See, the Mishmur says, but when the legislator, that's rabbinic, it's a rabbinic law. Even though the saying of the third paragraph is Doraisa. Particularly, they legislated that when you say the first two paragraphs, you should also say the last paragraph. So that's Rabbanan. That you should say it over at nighttime, when you say the Shema, that's rabbinic. The Doraisa is at nighttime. That they associate it, that they link it to the Shema, that's Tikdu Chazal. That's a rabbinic act.
You should say it.
You should say, because it's a tikkun chazal, haskim is my creation.
The last paragraph
has no relevance to the first.
Right, you can say that.
It has to be said at nighttime.
And what about the first thing in the Shema itself?
That has to be said when people are sleeping. That's literally.
It's
a kohod.
When we daven right now, we're davening at 8, Mitzvah in the Marv, right?
Yeah.
Too early, Myra. So we have to say Shema later?
Sure, yeah, definitely. Otherwise, you're not yotzei the Doraisa. They don't announce the Shul Krishma, should we say it over?
Right now, 8:05.
That's like after Shabbos or something. The earliest is Matzah Shabbos. 42 minutes after Sunday, after Shkia. That's the earliest time of night.
Even the 9 o'clock tomorrow, you know, it's too early.
Maybe too early.
Now it's up for another period.
Shabbos is over there.
9 o'clock wasn't so okay 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, it's not. See, today there's something phenomenal about shuls. They have an electronic board. Like, you know, some shuls they have, you know, when you want to announce the World Series scores by me. Rabbi doesn't announce it, they have an electric board. Today they have this money, and whatever you do, when you say Yalav Yavo, all the instructions on the electronic board. So, and you look, Shkia, regular Shkia, Rabbi Tam Shkia, everything else is there. So you want to be more lenient, more stringent, you just look at the board.
And 48
So it's just now. We could go.
And that's 42 minutes.
Right.
Okay.
So, Rabbi, though, so when we say Shema right now at 8:30, what are we really doing?
No, because when we say Meir, we're supposed to say Shema. Yeah, we're supposed to say Shema.
Right.
Right? I mean, right, so that's what
we're
saying.
We're not preparing the listening to Shema.
No, definitely. No. It's like, what about a person, Shabbos, they start late. You say Birchus Krishma, you say Shema. You have to say Shema before you came to Shul. Right? But yet, you do say Shema. If you omit it, the Birchus Krishma have value. But the proper way to say it is that the Shema should be preceded and followed with the prophets. Right? Although that Shema is only purely psukim, has no value as the mitzvah saying Shema. Because it's after the Shema, it's after the time. Okay? That's what Rashi says. Rashi says, you have to repeat it because you can yotzei Krishma Malita. So Tosa says a problem. Tosa says, you only say the first paragraph. For Krishma, you have to say two paragraphs, maybe three paragraphs. It's too early. Secondly, it's clear you're saying it for another reason, you're not saying it for that reason. You have to have in mind why you're saying it. You're just saying Kabbalah. you have to, this is, even though in church, you have to say it to fulfill the mitzvah of Kriya Shema. Right? You're saying it for Mishma Mazikim, in one sense, to be protected. That's why you say Kriya Shema Mazikim.
So it's a PDF, a PDF.
You can have multiple.
If you have in mind, people don't. That's the point. People don't have in mind. Right, and also, and what happens if people, some people say one paragraph from the Shema, the Krishma.
Right.
So if that's the case, and if you hold it, minimally, rabbinically, you have to have two. So on a rabbinical level, for sure, you're not using it.
If you're saying Kriya Shema, literally, both these factors anyway. You might get used to the idea of thinking that this is where you can be actually, so then you don't have to worry.
Not a problem. You know, it's like a person says, a person then says, thank you. Get into the habit of saying thank you. Same as we're saying, okay. My words are resonating, and my she said his mother used to tell him that. Okay.
When one says to me, I was up in the morning, the early Shema, in the morning.
So we had early, Ramos said earlier.
What should the Kavanah be?
He says that since there's a chance that you may miss this month, therefore you have in mind that in case you can miss this month, you know, some Siddurim have more than that one paragraph. You know, originally when we grew up, we used to have a particular name of Siddur, published by Hebrew publishing company. Right? There they just had Shema Yisrael, Shema Yisrael, Shema Yisrael. You didn't even have the whole paragraph. You did not have the paragraph. So according to that, you only say according to that one opinion, right, that it's the first pasuk. Rabbinically, definitely not. Today, they print in the Siddurim, they print the whole paragraph. Well, that's the first paragraph. There's some syndrome have more than that, right? But most have only the first paragraph.
So, did the Chazal legislate putting the first paragraph of the Shema there for this particular reason, or is there another reason?
No, most of course there's a chance you may not think there's a mountain.
So that's the particular reason.
And that's
the same as the Shema.
No.
Where's the third paragraph?
No, third paragraph is not a problem.
Because you're going to get to it anyway.
No. Third paragraph is not down by time of sleep. That you can say in the afternoon. That you can say in the afternoon.
It doesn't make you late because it's
exactly.
Because you get to it anyway.
Right.
That's the point.
That's the primary opinion. The primary opinion is the first paragraph.
So you can say something for
Krishna Mamita.
Yeah.
Okay, but there, what is worth having in mind? See, there it's cited explicitly. You should have in mind because you may be late. Later. Rishon you can say only because it's clear, it's because for protection. But you're right, if you have the additional intent, it's not a problem. Okay? Yes. Yeah, conditional. I mean, Shabbat. You know, you have the Mogen Avraham, and you have the Gro. Right? The Mogen Avraham, you have to say it earlier. The Vilna Gaon, you say it a little bit later. So when you say, but the proper way to say the Shema is the Birchas Shema. So when you say the Shema, even you say Shema before you come to Shul earlier, in Shul you're going to make the Shema, you should have in mind that I only want to be Yotze the Krishma I'm saying earlier only if the Avraham is like the Mogen Avraham. If the Aloha is not like the Mogen Avraham, I don't want to be Yotze with this Krishma. I want to be Yotze later because the optimum way to say Krishma is within the context of Birchas Krishma. Right? That's what you're supposed to have in mind. Same thing, we had in mind, you know, when you say Vayikulu Friday night, some sofa says, you should have in mind that you don't want to be Yotze with that. Because the proper way to say Kiddush Friday night, the Doraisa, is not a cup of wine. That's the proper way. But if you need Yotze in Shon Esrei, so when you come to Kiddush with the wine, it's only rabbinical. Then it's because you're already Yotze though, right? So you said that you're Shmon Esrei.
Same thing in the Same idea.
Same idea. You should have in mind that you have to Shmon Esrei.
It seems like
what do you have to talk about? Alan, what do you have to talk about? Very unnatural. Unless they're really B'nai Torah, they start late. They start 9 o'clock or a quarter to 9. That's it. They start late. Yeah, they tell people, say Shema before you come. That's what young people. That's not just modern, not modern. Just people like to sleep later. Shabbos, they start late. When people want to come with their children, they can't get their children earlier. It's easier to bring the kids late. That's the reason. Yeah. Okay.
When you say Shema early, before coming to the Shul, and then you say all of the Prophet with the Shema, you repeat it again?
Yeah, but you first, when you say it, you don't say the first paragraph. Right? When before coming to Shul, you say all three paragraphs before you hear the Shul.
Right? Don't say
it. You do say before Shul, you say all three paragraphs. Okay, I just want to do one more halacha. Hakorei Kriya Shema. Lo yirmos be'eino, v'lo yikros mitzvoso, v'lo yarem mitzvoso, parsha Yishama. A person should not wink with his eyes, should not make any motions with his lips, and he shouldn't point with his fingers. The parsha Yishama during the first portion. Why? Because it's a disrespect. I mean, he's supposed to be focused on Kavod Shem Shamayim. You know, all of a sudden, pointing to something, pointing to something, or you're making, you want to acknowledge somebody, you want to say Shema, you know, so you wink to a person. It's not respectful. This is during the first parsha, okay? Parsha Rishona. Shu'ika kabal somak Shema. The Gemara tells of a story. There was a person, I think it was Amram Chasido, that he was in the Shemon Esrei, and a knight comes, and he dismounts, and this Jew doesn't acknowledge him. He's infuriated. So what is he going to do? He's going to decapitate at the level of disrespect. He says, but he's not just going to do it. He wants to explain to him why he's going to decapitate. So he waits till he finishes the Shema Esrei and says, I want to explain to you why I'm going to kill you and decapitate you. I'm a knight. How do you not acknowledge me? So the rabbi says to the knight, so let me ask you a question. If I'd be involved with the audience of the king and you would come and I would interrupt my conversation with the king, to acknowledge you, what do I deserve? He says, you deserve people to death. He says, I was engaged speaking to the Creator. It's not a disrespect to you. It would have been a disrespect to the Creator if I would interrupt my conversation. Gets back on his mount. He's walking to the, you know, and that was the same thing. I mean, you've been Kabbalah Shemach Shemaim. You're accepting the dominion of Hashem. All of a sudden, you know, you're winking and you're making motions to indicate it's not respectful. No. He didn't realize. He wasn't aware that the knife was there. Looks like it's something you're just saying in passing. This is primary and the most important. The person signing the biggest deal of his life. And he can't be distracted. And somebody comes in. He's not gonna lift his head off that contract. No, to acknowledge anybody who walks in. That's how serious the moment is. That's when you say the Shema, that's how serious it has to be. Anything less than that is considered disrespect. Okay, just we're on this. Bob, lo yiros atibus bar mitzvah osu yiros. Koshkim shos alishov tabak v'krishma yiros. Person wants to smoke this, you know, smoke a cigarette while saying the Shema. What's wrong? You're not eating at his stand. Unless you're brought by him, focusing it. Right? So you're not permitted. Rashi Rishona of Gimel. The rain starts one before. There's no after the sun. Okay? Rashi Rishona of Yishmachim, Gam Pasha Shneo, after the Dvar Mitzvah, he says, even the second paragraph, he says, however, Achlid Bar Mitzvah, the Koli Alma, Mutal Gimbat Pashin, cited in the commentaries of the Rambam. Abul Hafsik Lehejelo, I am the Kabbat Simba, to interrupt speaking, definitely not. Still, you're not going to be able to speak, even if you're not saying it in the middle of Gifra's Kriya Shema. I'm saying Shema at home, and your wife asks you something while you're saying the Shema. And you go like this, you know, indicates, you know, she should wait. You shouldn't even lift your hand. Second paragraph, you put the Devar Mitzvah Shalom Bayis. First paragraph, he said, even the Devar Mitzvah. Even the Devar Mitzvah Shalom. Okay. So he had an X-ray taken of his lungs, and in those days the professors were in Warsaw, Varsha. And it was known the thieves in Warsaw, the mafia, didn't kill them. Thieves, they were all Jews. So, well, this is on the, so he gets off the train, puts his bags down. Man, Tzadik doesn't know about thieves, not thieves. Puts his bags down, turns around, and gone. Bags are gone. And his X-rays, that where he came from, the red cakes were in the bags. So he was advised, he has to go see the head of the mafia. Right? And if within moments you're gonna have the bags back, you'll have the X-rays back. So he gives him the address, he goes back to bed, you let him in. He's sitting at the head of his table. Talos Tillin, middle of Krishma, he can't interrupt. He waited until he finished the Krishma. Shimon Esrei told him what the problem. Within minutes, he had his bags. He walked to the doctor with his X-rays. Okay.